According to current Army doctrine, successful gap crossings require surprise, extensive preparation, flexible planning, traffic management, organization, and speed. Although each of the gap crossing fundamentals are critical to a successful operation, forces must be clearly task organized when conducting a deliberate wet gap crossing. Commanders conducting a deliberate gap crossing organize their units into assault, assured mobility, bridgehead, and breakout forces. Assault forces seize the far side objective to eliminate direct fire on the crossing site. A task force consisting of dismounted infantry and engineers may be organized as the assault force. Assured mobility forces provide crossing means, traffic control, and obscuration. These supporting units are task organized to perform specific tasks and are controlled using specific procedures that are clear, simple, and rehearsed by all elements to ensure responsive support of the plan and unity of command and effort. Assured mobility forces include combat engineer companies, mobility augmentation companies, multi-role bridge companies, and military police. A bridgehead force is a force that assaults across the gap to secure the enemy's side, the bridgehead, to allow the buildup and passage of a breakout force. One or more of the division BCTs normally serve as the bridgehead force during a deliberate wet gap crossing. The breakout force attacks to seize objectives beyond the bridgehead as a continuation of the offense. The division's reserve BCT may become the breakout force once the bridgehead is secure. Organized in this manner, forces are ready to conduct a deliberate wet gap crossing. Army Techniques Publication 3-90.4, Combined Arms Mobility, describes a wet gap crossing as a five-phase operation. These phases include advance to the gap, assault across the gap, advance from the far side, secure the bridgehead line, continue the attack. Phase 1, advance to the gap, is the attack to seize objectives that secure the near side terrain, which offers favorable crossing sites and road networks, and provides enough area to stage crossing forces while preventing congestion and an undesirable massing of assets. The seizing of this terrain sets the conditions for the assault across the gap. Normally, the division advances with two BCTs abreast and one trailing. The Division Tactical Command Post controls the effort of the lead BCTs. The Division Main Command Post controls aviation, artillery, and other assets in depth to isolate the crossing area and far side objectives. It also sustains the division advance to the gap by ensuring the key classes of supplies are positioned forward. Supply and maintenance priorities are adjusted to include crossing means, bridging units and equipment, and the assured mobility forces supporting the crossing. Each lead BCT main command post functions as the BCT's crossing area headquarters and is typically supported by an engineer battalion headquarters to help develop the crossing plan and control the crossing means within the BCT's crossing area. Once the lead BCTs have secured the near side, military police and engineers mark routes from the staging area to the crossing sites, lay out staging, holding, and call forward areas, and set up engineer regulating points and traffic control points. Phase 2, assault across the gap, involves units seizing the far side objectives. The intent of this phase is to rapidly place sufficient combat power on the far side to eliminate enemy direct fire onto the crossing sites and secure terrain for defensive positions and then attack positions. The Division Tactical Command Post, supported by an Engineer Brigade headquarters, coordinates the actions of the BCTs conducting the assault across the gap. The crossing sites are chosen based on available concealment, accessibility, and sufficient space for staging areas on the near side. These sites also have defensible terrain on the far side of the gap to provide a secure base for continuing the mission. Each BCT tactical command post controls its own respective assault crossing elements, which normally consist of dismounted infantry. Dismounted elements of the assault force cross the gap using assault boats operated by engineer units, via air assault, or other methods to secure terrain for the reinforcing armored vehicles. BCTs normally establish limits of advance and coordinated fire lines for the dismounted forces conducting the assault. This far side limit of advance will be graphically depicted as a phase line and will likely become a release line. During a gap crossing, a release line is used to delineate the crossing area. Release lines are located on the far side and near side and indicate a change in the headquarters that is controlling movement. Release lines are normally located within 3 to 4 kilometers of the gap and on easily identifiable terrain features. The release line on the near side is usually out of range of enemy direct fire weapons. The release line on the far side delineates an area large enough for forces to occupy battalion-sized attack positions. Collectively, the crossing area is about 6 to 8 kilometers. The dismounted assault forces are supported by tanks, infantry fighting vehicles, and other direct fire systems in support by fire positions. Heavy rafts are prepared to transport tanks and infantry fighting vehicles to the far side for reinforcing dismounted infantry. Commanders may consider immediate construction of a bridge during this phase without ever conducting rafting if this is viable. The advantage to this is that it may allow combat power to be massed on the far side at a much faster rate. The risk that the commander takes in making this decision is that a large amount of bridging assets are potentially exposed to enemy fires before the elimination of enemy direct and indirect fires on the crossing area. To mitigate this, each BCT main command post controls obscuration during crossing. The division main command post continues to control aviation, artillery, and other assets in depth to isolate the crossing area and far side objectives. The division main shifts fires to subsequent targets as units advance. It coordinates with the Corps for air and missile defense coverage to protect the crossing area from enemy air interdiction. The concentration and channeling of friendly forces for the gap crossing creates lucrative targets at relatively fixed locations that are easily targeted by enemy air. Therefore, approaches, holding, staging and call forward areas, crossing sites, and other critical nodes along the gap are the highest priority for air and missile defense protection during the crossing. Air and missile defense units occupy positions to engage aircraft with massed fires before the aircraft can reach weapons release points. This phase is complete once the far side objectives are secure. The third phase, advance from the far side, is the attack to secure the exit bank and intermediate objectives that eliminate direct and observed indirect fires into the crossing area. Each BCT main command post controls the movement of its follow-on forces from the staging areas across the gap to their attack positions on the far side. They control the upgrade of crossing sites from assault boats to heavy rafts or bridging in conjunction with the division operation order. The division tactical command post continues to control actions to secure the far side until the BCTs that make up the bridgehead force are set in attack positions. It then controls the coordinated attack of the lead BCTs from the far side attack positions through the exit bank objectives to the intermediate objectives. The division tactical command post may displace forward across the gap during this phase. Each BCT tactical command post, in coordination with the division tactical command post, controls the movement of its bridgehead forces out of their attack positions to the exit bank and intermediate objectives. Exit bank objectives are those positions that, when seized, eliminate enemy direct fire into the crossing sites. Intermediate objectives are those positions from which the enemy can provide observation for indirect fires. This enables the expansion of air and missile defense coverage, allowing more depth to engage aircraft in air avenues of approach on the far side of the gap. The division main command post controls aviation and artillery fires in depth to block enemy counterattacks into the bridgehead. During this phase, bridge companies run heavy raft sites and begin to construct ribbon bridges. Limited two-way traffic begins to allow for the return of disabled equipment and casualties by ground transportation. Military police and engineers provide traffic control on both the near and the far side of the gap to facilitate rapid transit within the crossing area. This phase ends once the intermediate objectives are secure. Phase 4, secure the bridgehead line, consists of the tasks necessary to secure the final bridgehead objectives while providing the time and space for the buildup of breakout forces. The lead BCTs of the bridgehead force attack to secure the final objectives within the bridgehead to prevent the enemy from successfully counterattacking by rapidly building enough combat power to establish a hasty defense. The hasty defense is temporary, and the priority remains crossing the gap as quickly as possible to reduce the risk to forces occupying assembly areas and continue the attack on the enemy. The lead BCTs maintain continuous far-side security to prevent bypassed enemy elements from infiltrating back to the gap and disrupting activities at the crossing sites. They control avenues of approach into the bridgehead and must have sufficient combat power to defeat enemy counterattacks. The bridgehead must be defendable and large enough to accommodate both the breakout force and the lead BCTs that seize it, normally 19 to 30 kilometers in depth. The Division Tactical Command Post controls the lead BCTs as they secure the bridgehead objectives and preparation is made to move the reserve BCT or other breakout forces into attack positions within the bridgehead. Once the bridgehead line is secure, the Division Main Command Post directs the movement of the breakout forces through the crossing area to attack positions within the bridgehead. The Division Main continues to control aviation and artillery fires in depth to screen the flanks and interdict enemy formations as they move to counterattack. The BCT Main Command Posts continue to monitor and improve the crossing sites and control the movement of forces through the crossing area. During this phase, specific bridges and rafts are designated for full-time return traffic. This ensures that ground resupply and the evacuation of casualties, detainees, and disabled equipment can occur. Once the breakout force has occupied its attack positions, the division is ready to continue the attack. The fifth phase is the attack out of the bridgehead to defeat the enemy at a final objective. This phase begins with a forward passage of lines as the breakout force passes through the hasty defense established by the bridgehead force. The lead BCTs of the bridgehead force must reorganize and prepare to follow the breakout force as the division or corps reserve. Security forces from the corps must come forward to relieve the lead BCTs from their bridgehead security mission. The Division Tactical Command Post moves forward or rejoins the Division Main Command Post and focuses on the attack out of the bridgehead and subsequent missions.